what's going on, my fellow YouTubers. How you guys doing? But happy Saturday to everybody. I hope you guys are doing great on this lovely Saturday. But I wanted to just, I had a little couple things on my mind, so I just wanted to talk about something. And what I want to say is that any man that has his shit together is a sexy motherfucker. Let me say that again. Any man that has his shit together is a sexy motherfucker. And the reason why, you know, I say that is because it's the fucking truth. A man that, you know, is responsible, you know, is about his business. He's on his purpose. He know who he is as a man. He know what his responsibilities is, and you know, he take care of his own, he takes care of his children, he takes care of his wife. That's a sexy nigga right there, you know what I'm saying? And I'm not saying that, you know, all I run into is deadbeats or people that, you know, don't have their own, but you know, I do, you know, I run into like a lot of men. I'm not even going to say that because I haven't dated. I haven't dated in so freaking long. But for a while, I was attracting Dusties and stuff like that. And I was attracting Dusties because a lot of times, you know, I didn't believe that I deserved better, you know. I didn't think that I deserve a man who was well off, you know what I'm saying? So I would attract men that had no job, that didn't have their own place, that didn't have their own car. But not even just that, you know what I'm saying? I'm not even going to sit there and say a man who has his shit together is a sexy nigga. Because you got a lot of men that do have money, but they're very stingy with it. You know what I'm saying? They're stingy men. You know, I know a lot of men that have money, but they're stingy as fuck with it. You know what I'm saying? They don't like to court women. They don't like to treat women and take them on dates and stuff like that. You know, they don't like to do any of that stuff. And then you see men that, you know, that bust their ass, and they might not have as much as a man that is, you know, making more money than them, but they're generous with their money, you know what I'm saying? They don't have much, but they're generous with it, and they don't complain about it, you know what I'm saying? You have a lot of men that simply complain about their position in life. You know, they complain about the fact that they were born a man, and they think that they shouldn't have to live up to certain standards of what is, you know, expected of them. You know what I'm saying? That's just a huge turnoff for any woman. You know what I'm saying? And a lot of times, you know, you have a lot of women on here, you know, that do videos and tell women how to get money out of men. And a lot of times, you know, I was turned off from those videos because, you know, I feel like, you know, I shouldn't have to finesse or trick any man out of his money. And if a man is, I made a video about this before. If a man is not generous, naturally generous with his money, then I don't want him. You know, I'm not going to beg or try to finesse you out your money. I'm just not going to do that. Number one, I'm too old for games. I'm too old for, you know, I'm too old for a lot of shit. You know, a lot of shit I'm just not going to do. I'm not going to beg a man to give me money. I'm not going to beg a man to take care of me. I'm not going to beg a man to take me out on a date. Because you know what? You know, I have a father. You know, he is naturally generous towards me. You know what I'm saying? Anything that I want, he gives it to me. And if he don't got it, he just don't got it. But anything that I want and that I need, he gives it to me. He don't make no complaints. He gives me, hey, here go some money. You know, go get your nails and feet and stuff done. He just gives me money. You know what I'm saying? He's my father, and he treats me like a spoiled princess. And, you know, I don't expect nothing less out of any man from what I'm already treated like. You know what I'm saying? So I already get the spoiled treatment from my father. So, of course, I expect a lot out of a man. But at the same time, I'm not going to beg you for money. Because, you know, I had men that were just willing to come out their pockets, you know, to treat me good, you know, to take me on a date or whatever. So, you know, if I feel like, you know, I got to beg and finesse you out your money, that's already a turn off. I'm like, ew, you stingy with your money and you want to get with me, you want to sleep with me, you want to have sex with me, and you don't even, you can't even come out your pockets, you know, the right way. You can't even, you know, take me shopping or, you know, give me money to get my, to pamper myself so I can look good for you, you know, to get my nails and feet and stuff done. That's a turn off for me, you know what I'm saying? And I don't have time for that, you know. I don't have time for that. You know, a stingy man is a huge turn off for me, a huge turn off. But it's nothing more sexy than a man that is on his purpose. He's generous with his money. You know, he's a down-to-earth gentleman. You know what I'm saying? That's a huge turn-on for women. And if you're not out here on your purpose, if you're not out here trying to be the very best version of yourself, and you're out here trying to get the best and the baddest of the women out there, you know, you're already lost. You know what I'm saying? And you're walking around here mad and bitter because you're not the man. You're not living up to your full potential. And you're walking around here mad at everybody, but you don't want to live up to your full potential. You don't want to put in the work. You don't want to put in the effort to get what you want, you know, out of life. You know, that ain't nobody's fault but your own. And, you know, from what I have learned, because, you know, I've seen men out here, you know, they know that if they want the best, if they want the baddest of the women, you know what I'm saying? They know what it comes with. You know what I'm saying? They know that they have to have their shit together, and not only have their shit together, but you also have to have a certain charm to yourself. You know, you have to be able to know how to talk to women. You have to be able to know how to, you know, court women. You know what I'm saying? It's just a certain way you have to know how to present yourself to women in order to get what you want. You know what I'm saying? A lot of men don't even know how to talk to women. You know what I'm saying? A lot of men don't know how to speak to women. You know, a lot of y'all are just full-blown assholes, and that's just a turnoff. And if, you know, if you don't got, I don't know, it's just a certain way that a man has to carry himself in order to turn me on. Because just because you got bread, you know what I'm saying, that don't turn me on just because you got bread. You know, you have, it's a certain way that I want to be treated. It's a certain way that I want to be talked to, you know, in order for me to be turned on. And a lot of y'all are just turned off. So, you know, that's just me speaking some real shit, you know. But that's it for now. I'm going to talk to y'all next video.